Most homeowners live with some artwork, others build their homes around it. In Naples, Florida, Gary Wasserman kept the interior of his home a monochrome white as a blank slate for his art collection. In his dining room, a 12-panel glass encased painting by Ken Aptekar that reflects on the life of Madame de Pompadour wraps around the entire room. A gallery-like hallway holds fluorescent paintings and a stainless steel sculpture of a cement mixer. On Fisher Island, Florida, Brazil-based furniture designer Paulo Bacchi combined two condos to create a second home for his family and about 25 pieces from his art collection. His home has minimal neutral furnishings and gallery-like lighting on pieces by artists like Damien Hirst and Andy Warhol. A 7-foot-tall, elliptical-shaped sculpture was placed between two floor-to-ceiling windows, grabbing attention against the backdrop of views. In Jupiter Island, Florida, Carol and John Rutherford's eclectic collection wasn't fitting into the remodel of their 1935-era historical home. So they hired architect Scott Hughes to design a pavilion on the property where the couple could display their art and entertain. He added a 64-foot pool and a covered breezeway in between to visually connect the two structures. In New York, David Horvitz and Francie Bishop Good worked with architect and interior designer Deborah Burke to design their apartment around their collection. In the entryway, they placed a large sculpture by artist Allison Saar. With about 860 pieces in their collection, the couple likes to rotate their works through the home regularly. Although many homes display artwork, the most serious art enthusiasts go to extremes to design homes around their collections, which take center stage.